Part of the synthetic cheat sheet taught you guys how to make new carbon-carbon bonds, and that's what I want to focus on in this topic. I really just want to destroy the entire concept of organometals and sodium alkynide alkylation. So basically, you guys know this is the only way to make carbon-carbon bonds in Orgo 1 is through organometals, and strong sodium alkynides are really commonly used organometals, and because they happen to be strong nucleophiles. Okay? And what that means is that since they're strong nucleophiles, they're often paired or reacted with alkyl halides because those are strong electrophiles. Okay? And what we can do is we can get a negative on a carbon to be attracted to a positive on a carbon, and bam, you have a new carbon-carbon bond, which is very important because synthesis relies on making bigger molecules from smaller ones. So if you can add carbons, that's really important. Okay? But for sodium alkynides, we're not just going to need to know that it's a nucleophile and it's an electrophile. We're going to need to know a few more things. How to generate the alkynide. So that means like alkynide synthesis, making it from scratch. We need to know how to do that. Also, after you've done your reaction, you also need to know how to transform the triple bond afterwards. So there's a lot to know here. We need to know how to make the alkynide, then how to use it, and then how to lose it, how to like do different things to it. Okay? So once again, I had this graphic that showed different nucleophiles. The ones we're gonna be dealing with mostly on this page, because I want you guys to get special practice with these, are the alkynides and the alkyl halides. Okay? So what we're gonna do first is we're going to start from this in kind of ascending hardness. We're going to start with the easiest problem. It's not easy, but it's not that bad. And we're going to work our way to progressively harder and harder problems where I'm going to take you further and further back in the synthetic process. And you're going to have to figure out everything from the very beginning, okay? But in this case, like I'm telling you right now, this is not such a bad question. Let me coach you through it and see if you can get it. Because notice that right now, first of all, I'm already starting with a triple bond. That's awesome. Because if you're going to notice, I have three carbons in this molecule. I have four carbons in the other. Okay? What does that mean that must have happened at some point? Okay? If you added carbon, that means you must have used an organometal. Okay? And like I said, the most common organometal in this chapter is going to be the sodium alkynide. And I already have a triple bond. So there's a huge giveaway that I just need to use that triple bond. All right? So basically what you should be thinking is, how many carbons do I need to add to the triple bond for it to make four? And then what do I need to do to that triple bond after so it looks like a double bond that looks like that? Okay? So that was enough hints. I'm just trying to coach you guys. So this isn't totally like, you know, totally like a train wreck. And I'm going to stop the video and you guys try to answer it the best that you can.